YouTube channel. Just refreshed myself. Forgot to brush my teeth. Can you believe it? I think I brush my teeth in the morning already, then I eat food. I usually try to brush my teeth twice, before and after, so you feel fresh after as well. Because when you got the food, like if you eat the food in the morning, then you got that dirt on your teeth, and then you eat the food along with the dirt in the teeth, which is kind of disgusting. You have to brush your teeth, and then you eat food, but then that ruins the freshness of your mouth. But then you have to. Then again, brush your teeth. Oh, Jesus Christ, man. What I want to talk about today is, sorry if you see the light glisten off my big ass forehead, I just have to get refreshed. What I want to talk about today is, so what if you get zero views? So what if you get no views? So what if no one watches your videos? Who cares? This entire channel is me practicing exposing myself, literally exposing myself, telling my deepest, most darkest, embarrassing stories in order to build up my confidence, to post myself on YouTube, to make more videos. So what if you get zero views? It's actually worse if you get views. In all honesty, it is worse, because then you start making money, and then you start like being open to scrutiny. You might get a lot of support, but you might be open to even more scrutiny, and the scrutiny, the negativity is far louder than the positivity. I guarantee you that for sure. Because when you're reading comments, it's like texting someone. It feels like that person is a real person insulting you to your face. And you can't even do anything about it. You can't even stand up for yourself. It's quite... I'm not crying. I'm just... There's something in my eye. It's quite a fucking... How do I say this? It's quite... Not necessarily humiliating, but it's quite... like a weird thing to go through. Social media has made everyone so uncomfortable. So, not uncomfortable, or very comfortable with disrespecting each other over the internet. Or any actual physical repercussion. You know? Social media has bred assholes. Literally. A generation of assholes. I remember Patrick McDavid. No, it was not Patrick McDavid, it was Dana White and Grant Cardone. And Grant Cardone said, if you have that savage within you, and this links into the sort of get zero views, by the way. Because if you have that savage in you, you will run through this generation. Because the majority of the generation, perhaps 1 to 5% of the generation, are actually disciplined, willing to work, on self-improvement, grinding. If you're around the self-improvement space, you see them a lot. But if you're in reality, you're on the streets. Fuck, this guy just ran through here.
Fongy?
But if you're in reality, you're on the streets, you see everyone in central London, everyone's fat, skinny fat. Or skinny. Everyone's physically inadequate. They're broke. They look kind of geeky. Sad to look at. The majority of people don't even look good. And this isn't to like toot my own horn. Like, yeah, I'm really super handsome, guys. I'm not even that super handsome. But I did my best in order to look the best I possibly could. And before, I used to look fat as fuck. And I changed myself. With hard work and dedication. And so many people are still... literally unable to get fit. Like, unless the images, I don't even look good right now. But then on the images, I look much better. But most people, they don't. All the rewards for life are there for the taking, but they just don't take it. It's so easy to complain. Complain that it's this guy's fault, complain that it's that guy's fault. I used to be like this as well. A few short year ago. And 2 years ago, I used to be just like this. And my mom still harkens back to it to insult me. It was like mockingly, like tease me or some shit. But it doesn't work anymore. Because I'm not like that anymore. You have to have that savage inside of you. The savage inside of you that will upload 300 videos and get zero views on all of them. But then you're used to uploading yourself. So you got some actual experience on YouTube. I don't know how many videos I have. I wish I could check. Motel. That didn't show me my own videos, bro. It usually shows you right here. It shows you the videos that you have. Some L YouTube, man. Okay, I can see on my phone. Where's my phone? Here it is. I have 1 hour and 40 minutes phone usage today. Turn that time down. That shit on 0 minutes. Fuck that shit. One hour. Yesterday was 5 hours. 5 minutes. It was quite intense. But I was talking to my friends and I was surfing the YouTube. Not the YouTube, the Chrome. And then the day before that, on Wednesday, 8th of March, it was 1 hour, 28 minutes. And my lowest so far has been 28 minutes on Monday, the 6th of March. And my second lowest is Saturday, 4th of March, 53 minutes on my phone. And I could easily use YouTube on my computer. I don't. I literally just upload. I record videos and I upload. And I spend the majority of my time trying to edit videos, trying to get some work done. I should make it. I have to make a video soon. Not should. I should literally make a video soon. I have to in order to make a video soon. How I've reduced my YouTube input output. I reduced my YouTube input so much and then increased my output so much. I got 10. I'm about to supersede my main channel. I got 55 videos. I got no views. One of them, I got one view. Sick. How many views I got? 318. Fucking joke. I don't care. I don't care, guys. Because I know we're like... When I reach the 600 video mark, people are going to notice me. And on my main channel, when I reach like the 100, 200, 300, 400 video mark, people are going to notice me. Especially with the highly edited videos. With this type of channel content, I can like shit out videos a lot because all I'm doing is recording it into the camera and then talking and then typing the video and then uploading it. That's it, done, boom. But with the edited videos, that takes time. So it'll take time, but it'll be all worth it at the end. So what if you get zero views? Make more videos. That's it. Catch you at the next one. Peace. Remember, hard work is easy for me.